It was the news that sent shockwaves around the world that long-running soap Neighbours had been dropped by Channel 5 in the UK, the channel that co-funded the production, which means the future of the series is in doubt. The cast and crew gathered yesterday for a meeting about the show's future, and Geoff Payne has played Dr. Clive Gibbons on Neighbours on and off for 36 years, and he joins us now. Geoff, thanks for joining us this morning. So, there was this meeting out at the Nunawading Studios where Neighbours has been filmed since 1986 yesterday. What were cast and crew told?
Well, basically, it is the news that Channel 5 in the UK are looking for, looking basically to end their investment in Neighbours. Channel 10, of course, are keen to keep the show going and are looking for a new production partner. But it has been 36, 37 years of the show, and I guess viewing habits have changed, and Channel 5 is looking to change its kind of menu of shows that it's got on at the moment.
How do you and the rest of the cast feel? I mean, what a body blow.
Well, I guess the show's gone through various iterations over the years, and to be honest, I think there's been contract negotiations, as this happens in television over the years, and always been rumours that it may go for another 2 or 3 or 4 years. So I think it's just the actual announcement being made that has really brought people together to go, OK, how can we keep this going and how will it change in the future?
Yeah, it's been such devastating news. Jason Donovan tweeted that he's absolutely gutted by it because it has given so many opportunities and launched so many careers. What sort of part has Neighbours played in your career? You joined way back in 1986 as Dr. Clive Gibbons, but you've sort of gone in and out.
I have. So I only did it for a year when I was the old Dr. Clive. It was a long time ago. I had hair back in those days. This was decades ago. And it was my first job out of drama school. And I was thrown into this mad kind of crazy world of Neighbours and Ramsay Street and the character and making this stuff very, very quickly. We're making the equivalent of a feature film every week, so it has to be done really quickly. So it kind of launched me into this world of show business, and over the years I've done different sort of stuff in TV and film and radio and that sort of thing. So it was the oxygen that kind of lifted me up. And over the past few years I've come back as the older, more senior, one of the old boys of the show, which is kind of funny. but it's literally thousands of actors have come through the show. It's been like this institution that has pumped out talent, singers and actors and performers and crew and directors who've gone on to do bigger and better things. So it has been this kind of show business institution in a way.
Yeah, and long may it continue. Just watching you and Colette Mann having a bit of a pash there, it's all good stuff. you are an esteemed oldie character now. I think you're head of the hospital, aren't you, of the Erinsborough Hospital?
I am. I like the term esteemed oldie. It's like national treasure. It means not dead yet.
but I have got my hands on your first appearance on Ramsay Street in 1986, a bit before your character became a doctor. Clive was a gorillagram. Take a look.
What's going on here?
Get out of here, will you?
Come on, Clive. I'm running out of light.
Listen, we're trying to get some photos taken here.
Oh, what for?
Forget it. We've got the village idiot here.
There's an idiot here, all right, mate, but it isn't me.
God, it's hot in this thing.
How's that cold?
Great, you saved my life.
I'm Denny Ramsay.
Hi, Denny. Clive Gibbons.
It's quite the character evolution.
Wow. Yes, I know. I don't know what's more shocking, the gorilla suit or the spiky hair back in those days, but we all had mullets, basically, spiky mullets. Yes, it was quite a start. And, yes, my first entry into television was in a gorilla suit, and I'll never live that down. In fact, trying to explain what a gorillagram was is tricky to anyone that wasn't there at the time.
Yeah. Where did the name Clive Gibbons come from?
So I'm aware that there is a bunch of conspiracy theories about this, and to the best of my ability, all I know is that Clive Gibbons, I think, is a real person that the original show's producer knew growing up, and it was basically an in-joke that he invented a character called Clive Gibbons. Now, what does the internet say?
The internet says it was based on a song from the Goodies. This one.
Feel, do, the funky Gibbons. Just like you, come on and be funky Gibbon now.
I like that story.
Yeah, look, happy to go with it. I'm not sure that there's a connection with the goodies, but, look, happy to go with it if people... I love the goodies myself and remember the song. But as far as I know, there is someone whose life was mildly tortured by actually having the name of someone in an Australian soap in the 1980s.
Look, Geoff, fans are up in arms about this. There are petitions in the UK and even one BBC journalist trying to start crowdfunding to get production costs. Fans want it to continue. Do you think Neighbours will go on?
Well, we can only hope that that's the case. At the moment, it's extraordinary that there is this kind of crowdfunding, GoFundMe sort of idea to keep the show going. It's a different world and our viewing habits are changing, as we know, right around the world, and there's so many more options to choose from. But it's also a kind of a stable in people's lives for millions of people, both here and in the UK. So we can only hope that a production team or production company can say, OK, we think we can keep this going. Whether it changes the format, whether it changes the kind of look of the show, we don't know. But it is part of the schedule of many people's kind of working weeks.
So true. Neighbours airs, of course, weeknights at 6:30 on 10p. Geoff Payne, it's been lovely to have you chat with us. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Angela.
Danny Venn has a dessert that's really, really easy and really delicious and actually pretty good for you.